Yeah, I've definitely only been in the job a short time, but we had mixed results leading in. But I do think we learned a lot in Pakistan in that pre-tour. I think to have a series like that where it went down to the wire and we got over the line, I think gave the group a lot of confidence, and we learned a lot about ourselves there. I think T20 World Cups are difficult. I think getting out of the group stages is always part of the key to getting the end result. And I think obviously after the loss to Ireland, I think it was a bit of a sting in the tail for us, and we had to reflect pretty quickly and move on. And probably the rest is history now. But it wasn't all plain sailing, as most World Cups, you have a hiccup somewhere along the way. But immense satisfaction. Very happy group afterwards. Celebrated well and accordingly, I guess. Not a lot changed. I think the group is pretty much the same, so we don't change a lot in the white ball team. But I think it's exciting, obviously, seeing Jofra come back. To see someone of that caliber come back into the group is exciting for everyone. We don't play a lot of ODI cricket before the next World Cup, so a lot of what we'll be doing is seeing how players are playing in their franchises or the domestic competitions as well before we sit down to pick that ODI team. But generally speaking, I think it's exciting. I think this South African series is sort of the start there. I think the series in Australia felt like it was at the back end of the T20, whereas this is the sort of start of our campaign towards the World Cup. Gathering bits of information, not just on us, but the opposition, is going to be really important. Yeah, I think it's something Joss has been very big on, is us continually sort of challenging to get better every day. And I think that's something that really resonates well with the group. I think there's a realisation that there's there's obviously some real success in the past, but this team sort of charting its own course and making sure it's got its own identity. And I think we went away to do that with the T20 World Cup. But they don't come around too often, one day World Cups, and it's a real opportunity for this group to stamp themselves in that format. I think there's still a lot of positions up for grabs. I think we've got abundance of talent that are all desperate for an opportunity. So that's exciting. Well, as selectors, we're going to have some really tough decisions come that World Cup 15, but I think that puts us in a good spot. I think the competition for spots will keep everyone up and about and ready for every opportunity, so that's all you can ask for. It's always much talked about the batting depth, but I think what we've seen over the last 6 to 12 months is a real emergence of the bowlers and the way that they've adapted to the different formats and found a way to really compete. And that was a big part of the success in the T20 World Cup. Was I think everyone was confident our batting had the skills to do it, but I think the way that those bowlers stepped up and changed the game, particularly someone like Sam Curran, who became a household name basically throughout that World Cup through his performances, and halfway through that summer he was really competing for spots, so that should be a real boost for all of our bowling group. He just brings an amazing X factor. I think I think he's just one of those people that you want to turn on the TV and watch. Drags people out of the bars at venues because every time he comes on the bowl, it's exciting. And I've seen it from a distance. I'm really looking forward to having him on the team that I support. And I think everyone in this group gets a real boost when he's around, and it's quite obvious. For me, it's a brilliant opportunity. I think any team that goes in thinking they're going to defend a World Cup, you can come unstuck. I think everyone starts on the same points. You all go in the same venues, and it's really important you go out and try and win the World Cup. And in that format, I think the best teams generally get through the final. I think it's a little less fickle than the T20 World Cup, so we've just got to make sure we're playing our best cricket. I think it's a really fair format as well. Like, you play everyone, and you get an opportunity to show what you are as a team. And for us, it's as I said, it's fresh, it's new, it's a new group, new captain as well. So I think we're just going out there and do our best to try and win it from the start.